The tribes made it abundantly clear that they believe that they have rights under federal law that they are going to pursue regarding any impacts to the tribal interests. I don't think our job is to provide a seat at the table for the tribes who want to be treated as a sovereign in negotiation.
I was wondering, do you know who wrote this bill?
I think it was a combination of a bunch of people, don't you?
Did anyone sponsor this bill?
I think it was sponsored, don't you?
Were there any legislators who sponsored this bill?
I think there was, don't you?
Was there an author assigned to this bill?
I believe there probably was someone that took credit for that.
Right,
don't
so
you?
Was that public?
Who wrote it?
Who wrote this bill?
Who wrote it?
Stone, I was wondering if you knew the author of this bill?
I don't.
Do you know any co-sponsors of this bill?
Oh, the bill was actually a committee bill. It was introduced as a committee.
Okay, so who wrote the language of the bill?
I'm not sure.
As committee chair, do you know who authored this bill?
You'll read it in the paper.
Are there any co-sponsors of this bill?
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. First of all, I don't know the comments the gentleman from the 24th make, but I have been quoted as saying it's the most significant jobs legislation we're going to take up this session. But I guess today's the day we finally figure out the rhetoric from the reality.
Then I'd like to make a motion that we add bills that have been sitting around for a long time, Assembly Bill 9, 10, 16, 17, 20, 21, 22, 25. You can see these are all bills that have been really since the first month of session. They're all jobs bills.
But I guess today's the day we finally figure out the rhetoric from the reality.
Bring them up, obviously, at the best committee, at least, but I think it'd be very important to add to these. I think we all feel deeply about jobs bills, and I think that's something on a bipartisan basis we can all agree upon, and I would just make the motion that we add to these.
Well, thank you, Mr. Chair. We're taking a look at all the bills that are before the legislature, but to rush the committee process at an organizational committee hearing, I think, is
appropriate. That's a pretty ironic statement to make, given that there's no committee hearing on this reapportionment bill. It's a huge change. It seems to me that if we can rush reapportionment, not following the statutory provision that we're supposed to wait for the board lines to be drawn on the local level first, then if we can rush that, the issue I think our constituents would rather see rushed would be jobs related.
And I said, there's going to be a time where you get a chance to vote for jobs, real job creation. And I want to know when Democrats and when people on that side of the aisle are going to really be sincere about creating jobs.
After that, then the chances are we won't be back in session till fall, unless you can tell me some difference from the majority leader. But I assume you're not planning on being back. So why would we delay on bills to create jobs for our constituents? And it just seems to me that we ought to be putting our constituents first. And I think these are all good bills. I see no reason why we wouldn't want to put those on the ball and you know, bring forward and do something positive.
I don't know how anybody from Iron County would be able to vote against this piece of legislation. I don't know how Democrats with a straight face can sit here and say, you're for job creation, we're not, and you're going to vote against this bill today? Well, then the rhetoric's come to fruition. Well, then the rhetoric's come to fruition, because now everybody knows that really you just like to talk a good game. You just like to talk a good game.
President Vargo, I've seen some of your comments. All you're saying is rushed process, it's unprecedented. That's just not the case. This was done in the exact same way in 1983 to the day. So I think it's good rhetoric, President Barco, but not exactly reality.
Milwaukee legislators, really? Do you not know who you have in your backyard? The largest manufacturer of mining equipment? It's called Caterpillar. Look it up. This will save jobs in Milwaukee. To answer your question, gentleman from the 37th, Mr. Speaker, I would ask unanimous consent that myself and all Republicans be made authors of this legislation. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
I take it some of y'all want to be co-sponsors? All right, you got a pen ready? Nope. 14, 5, 6, 32, 27, 60, 83, 66. Did I miss anybody? Yeah, why don't we just make it all Republicans?
I met with the governor, I don't know, 5-6 times. You know, each time I brought these things up, for some reason, we never put them on a special session call. We were going to try and work together more closely, and what we're doing today certainly is going to help that process. They include these jobs bill, that will at least build a little positive working relationship, and it's doing something positive for the state, something needed, something essential.
Further discussion? Not? Clerk, call the roll.
Representative Fitzgerald.
No.
Representative Souter.
No.
Kramer.
No.
Baldwin.
No.
Parker.
Aye.
Bolsey.
Aye.
Boris.
Aye.